Andrew, it's a few months since you were announced as Rugby General Manager at the Ospreys. For those who don't know, what does the job entail and really how did it come about?
The easiest way to explain it is to make sure the integration of the rugby departments is there. The three main parts being the senior environment, the performance, which is the elite youth development, and the development part of the programme, which is Ben Rose and the community department. How did it come about? Well, with Andrew moving up to the CEO, there was a big hole left there. Andy Lloyd moving over to recruitment, retention and player welfare and specialising in that area. There was a need really to make sure that, like I said, the integration of rugby philosophy was across the board.
Is it the kind of thing where you're providing the glue that holds the whole rugby department together?
Yeah, you know, it's just making the philosophies and the strategy and all the, you know, the programmes that we got are interlinked and the messages are consistent, and the values and behaviours that, you know, that we've worked hard putting in place is right through the business and not just to the senior group.
You came into the role at a difficult time for regional rugby and for Welsh rugby in general. How has that affected you on a day-to-day basis?
It's a difficult time, but to be honest, at ground level, you just have to get on with it. It's not ideal, but it exists, and we just have to manage that as best we can. Like I said, from an operational point of view, we just get on with the job.
It's important at times like this, really, that everybody pulls together, and that's supporters, commercial partners, you know, that you work hard for the better of the Ospreys.
Everyone involved, really, and you know, it is important, you know, players, coaches, administrators, spectators, commercial partners, that we all pull together and, you know, to take us forward, and that every penny spent is reinvested in what we do. You know, I mean, particularly in the development area of the youngsters coming through, because we've based out, you know, what's going to take us forward, is that's where it's going to come from.
You're touching on the investment in the development. There's been a lot said in certain corners of the media over the summer about the Ospreys, where we are with the squad at the moment and moving forward to next year and beyond, but it's part of a wider strategy.
Yeah, you know, there's been a lot said in the press, but where we are from a rugby point of view, they've been made for rugby decisions with a long-term strategy, you know, that's been put in place and we put a year or two into to take us and be successful for the future. So, like I said, there has been changes, but the changes are rugby decisions with a view to investing in development and young players to ensure long-term success.
And with your previous role at the union, based at the Ospreys, running the development pathway, you probably know better than anybody about the investment that's been made by the Ospreys, 600% increase in investment over the last 3 or 4 years, and you know where the money's being spent for the future of the region.
Well, definitely, you know, the size of our department, which was aided on top of what the WU supplied from a staffing and resource point of view, a massive investment from the region. And with the current game, you know, commercially, the way the game is, it's where the money needs to be spent, because we can only succeed by, you know, development from within, which is one of our philosophies, and investing in the young guys coming through and making sure that there's a continual conveyor belt of that coming through.
You've touched on the support of the union in terms of the existing development pathway, but with the new agreement being signed, it's positive news for the Ospreys, and particularly with the development coming within in-house entirely, then it means we have even more control over what goes on in terms of development.
Yeah, you know, it's a natural evolution of being in charge of our own destiny, I suppose, where the academies, development pathways, whichever they be called, becomes regionalised, which means we can totally control and shape which way we want to take our development arm, and rightly so, while you know, still maintaining relationships with the union through national age grades, under 18s and under 20s for Wales, and working in conjunction with the National Academy. I think it's only right that the academies become regionalised.
And one thing perhaps people don't realise when it comes to the decisions being made on players and contracts is the succession planning that's in place, and the fact that when you see a player leaving, it's with a view to what we've got, not just in the first team at the moment, but further down the line, under 16s, under 18s.
Yeah, as you said, succession plans are everything. We've split the region into East and West at under 16, so therefore increasing our numbers and tracking them players all the way back to under 16s and keeping an eye on where there's shortfalls, where we're strong, where we're not, identifying that. and making sure we fill them gaps. And like I said, going back to what we talked about at the beginning, the long-term strategy of you know, development from within and them youngsters coming through.
And on the dawn of a new season, it's quite an exciting time as far as the Ospreys are concerned. And you're looking ahead with young players, new competitions, new commercial partners. Everything looks promising.
Yeah, it's exciting. Do you know what I mean? I can't see it being plain sailing. And that's part of it. I just think it's a real exciting time, as you said. There's new competitions, new opportunity to, you know, to be in charge of our own destiny with being able to negotiate our TV deals and commercial deals. I think that's key to us moving forward. So yeah, real exciting times coming.
You've touched on some of the aspects of it, but the new agreement was signed on Thursday, and it's very positive for the Ospreys, very positive for Welsh rugby. But there's probably a word of caution as well at the start of what is a new era for the Ospreys.
Yeah, you know, glad the agreement's done, but it's not a case of all the work has been done and sit back and enjoy that. No, it's really this is the start of where we go next. So for definite, it's great that everything's been agreed, and hopefully the regions, the national team and the development pathways within that can all move forward. But it is a case of now the work starts and looking at how we're going to take us to the next step.